That said, I'm not very good at telling right from left either, but we're not going to go into that because that is shameful. So you can go to a repair garage, which we'll go ahead and do now. We'll heal up our MP. And I guess I'll go ahead and heal the close status on Anubis, because I'm going to be using Anubis a little bit. And you can buy items from the repair garage. You're not, like, a whole bunch of items, but there's a few useful ones there if you find yourself in the lurch. So now we want to fuse these two for probably, no, not probably, the best demon in the entire game. And I think she is the most powerful neutral demon in the game. Even though she's not the highest level demon in the game. I think all the demons that are higher level than Shiva are aligned. So, if you're playing one of the other two alignments, if you're on Chaos, Lucifer joins your party, and he kind of fulfills the role of Shiva here. And if you're playing on Lost Side, then Satan ends up in your party. I won't, like, explain, like, what events happen for Satan to, like, side with you, but let's just basically say shit hits the fan. Unfortunately, Lucifer is not a very good demon. I think Satan is better, but I'd have to look at him. But Lucifer's not useful at all. Like, he's just got a lot of hit points, and that's really it. Alright, so let's see. They face, yeah, they did, okay. So I need to face south now. And east. Nice. So, one of the great things about Anubis versus Shiva versus Anubis is, you might notice that Shiva actually has a lot of MP, which means she can cast Divine Retribution 4 times. She's got enough to cast it 4 times, whereas Anubis only has enough to get one shot in. That's really great. So between the two demons, I now have 5 shots of Divine Retribution, which is enough to take out a lot of hit points. So we are now on the 54th floor of the Ark. And this is kind of a mini teleporter puzzle, I think. Like, it's very straightforward, so. Pretty sure. Yeah, all you do is just follow the numbers. Like, there's no what is the word here? There's no branching paths here, mostly. I think if you misstep in one spot, you end up in a, going backwards or something. About in the bottom corner there, like if you turn around and go back, you end up having to repeat some of it, but largely it's very just go into the next room. Let me see. Mess up. Oh, I was wrong. There is a branching path. Look at that. Did I mess up again? I think I messed up again. No, I didn't. Okay, cool. So this is the branching path. I was wrong. There is one. Oh. Still, this place is not super complicated. So we need to go to, there's actually two here. And I think they both go to the same one. Yeah. Okay, so this is not that bad. And this is the exit. So this is what the room looks like. So you actually, to get to the exit, that top left room, that's where you need to go. It's marked, if you're using the same map as I am, it's marked P7. Interesting. Elohim, born in defiance of God's will, you summon demons and fight constantly. No, that's the third game. Alright, so sword. And this time we just do two. Two Tarokajas. Extra Divine Retribution. Divine Retribution. So, if Elohim does his Elohim's Light move, which I think he can still do, even though his magic is sealed, I think it will kill Anubis. It'll stone Anubis. So, we're good in that. Alright, so Elohim has 7,592 hit points, so he's got way more hit points than the previous two bosses. But now we have Shiva, so we have two Divine Retributions. I just took off 3,000 hit points in one turn. What are they gonna do? So this is the second Tarokaja. So, honestly, I don't think that... I think one of the things... Well, obviously, Divine Retribution is really good. But I think it would be less good and less required if the bug wasn't there that caused your... attack to overflow. So So as you can see, you can freeze Elohim with Masakado's katana. They seem to have some resistance to it. Like, it doesn't happen nearly as often. Than most of the other enemies in the game, and I'm not 100% sure why, but it's fine. So now we are level 74. Alright, so now we're on the other side of this, and I could walk back if I wanted to, but I'm not. I'm going to use Hiranya's instead. Parvati's still got plenty of MP. I just need to get you up close to 135. One more will do you. And Shiva. I need to get you up to 320 or so. The problem with the Hiranyas is they restore a very small amount of MP. But there's really nothing better in the game that's easy to get. There might be other items to restore MP. I can't think of any off the top of my head, but the Hiranyas are the easiest to get. So, and I've got plenty of Hiranyas. One more. Nice. Okay. All right. So now we are up these stairs. This floor is really straightforward. All these rooms are empty. But yeah, it's three empty rooms. And through this door is our good buddy Zane slash Shiva. Let me make sure I'm ready here. Oh, right. Item equip. Roko. Unfortunately, the Fergus sword is not going to cut it. We need to get as close to 200 hit as you can possibly get. Unfortunately, I feel like Hiroko has very few options in this arena. You can do some sword fusion if you want to get her some stuff. The two easiest things to get are the Cat of Nine Tails, which, while the attack power is a little low at this point, it still has lots of hits, and it has decent hit. It has 50 hit. And the Longinus Spear, which hits 2 to 4 times and has 60 hit. So, basically God's plan is to just wipe out humanity and let them live dumb, stupid lives. Plot dump. The true God. Ooh. So, in the first game, God doesn't appear. Like, you end up fighting, the final boss is like an angel, I think. I don't remember what the final bosses are in the first game, honestly. They're like throwaways. They're like the leaders of the factions, aren't they? You don't fight Lucifer and you don't fight God. But the creators of the series have said that the God in these games is actually crazy. And something went wrong. There's like something fundamentally wrong with the universe, and it drove him mad. So now we fight Satan. With his glowy eyes. He turns into... turns into a giant dragon with a skull face. That's metal, man. Okay, so Satan has a move that can just instantly kill one of your people. As long as it isn't Shiva or a human, don't worry about it. Just go all in. Probably Anubis is going to be the one to die. That's one of the reasons why I bring Anubis into the final battles. Like, obviously, I get my shot in with the Divine Retribution, but Anubis is a lot lower level than the rest of my demons, so... he's going to eat that hit, basically. Nice. So I think I have enough hit to hit Satan. Let me see here. So, Satan has, let me see, he has 180 evasion, so I have right under his evasion. So Hiroko is going to be able to hit him pretty reliably. It's not going to be like it will be with YHVH. She's going to miss a lot. But that's fine, that's fine. If it gets to be too bad with her, what I'll have her do is just support us with magic. With Dear Rahans and stuff. But in this fight, she's still pretty useful. She'd be even more, she'd hit even more reliably if I went out of my way to get the longiness, but I didn't in probably what I'm going to have Hiroko do in the final battle is just throw Haranyas constantly at Shiva. I don't think I told you how many hit points Satan has. He has 12,500 hit points. So he has a lot of HP. This is a really long battle if you do not have Divine Retribution. I would probably do better switching out Anubis for, Kukulain, but... this is where probably having some react sheets would be useful, where I could have Hiroko actually switch the demons without having Aleph take a turn. But I don't have any react sheets. So that's not a thing I can do. Parvati, you just attack this round. That one last Divine Retribution in. Uh-oh. Bit of lag there. And she died. Okay, so I'm actually going to heal Hiroko here. I'm gonna, I'm gonna revive Hiroko because she gets experience. And I don't want her to miss out on the levels. And we'll have you use Madeira Han. Oh, gosh. This is not good. Damn it! This is about as bad as it could have gotten here. Let's do this. But this is why I have these Kintans. Oh. Nice. Okay. So, we're good. We're good. We're good. Let's go ahead and summon Kukulane. Do I want to? Yeah, let's go ahead and summon Kukulane. Attack. Attack. And Hirokos, you are fast, so save Aleph. Nice, okay. Cool. Give me two more levels, yeah? I was hoping for another point to hit, but whatever. Ooh, I learned Recarm. That's pretty good. Just what are you going to do? We kill the Batman. Excuse me. We fight God. There's actually some hint that Aleph didn't escape the wrath of God. Yes. And this is a point of no return. So.